Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. An Afghan shopkeeper wanted in connection with the murder of his ex-partner and her mother would regularly brag about having two wives, it was claimed today. Janbaz Tarin, 21, is being hunted by police after Raneem Oudeh, 22, and her mother Khaola Saleem, 49, died from stab wounds in the early hours of yesterday. The Syrian-born women were pronounced dead at the scene outside Ms Saleem's house on a quiet residential street in Solihull, near Birmingham. West Midlands Police said they had launched a major manhunt for the suspect, who still remains at large, and neighbours claimed he was an arrogant man. Police also revealed today that Ms Oudeh had a two-year-old son, although she did not have him with Tarin, while Ms Saleem had six children. Janbaz Tarin is on the run after he is believed to have stabbed his ex and her mother to death. Raneem Oudeh, 22, has been named as one of the women found dead in Solihull yesterday. Ms Oudeh, left, and her mother Khaola Saleem, right, died after they were stabbed in Solihull. Neighbors of the house where he used to live with his parents in Sparkhill said he would often joke about having two partners, one in Britain and one in Pakistan. Shahida Mahmood, 45, said, the family were originally from Afghanistan but lived in Pakistan for a bit and he had a wife there as well before moving here. He would laugh and joke about having two wives and brag about it quite a bit because he said they didn't know about each other. I told him it wasn't funny to laugh about that but he thought it was hilarious for some reason. But he seemed a nice guy and I would see him around a lot. He would always say hello. He would go and see his dad about 3 times a week but recently he stopped coming. He helps his dad run a shop. Neighbor Mohammed Faisal, 21, added, he moved out about 1.5 years ago and the last time I saw him was last week. Tarin, pictured, is wanted in connection with the deaths of two women in Solihull. Evidence cones, leading a trail from the crime scene, were put down by detectives today. One neighbor said Afghan shopkeeper Tarin, above, was a nice guy and really respectful. He had 4 big pizzas and was taking them down the local mosque. He was a nice guy and really respectful. He honestly seemed a genuine, friendly guy. His parents are lovely people and his dad helps me with my car sometimes. They will be really worried about him. Police were there yesterday turning the place over. Another local resident, who did not want to be named, added, I met him in the shop a few times and he seemed a bit arrogant to me. The cordon outside Carola's £225,000 home was extended this morning while police carried out further searches at the scene. Detectives have said anyone who sees Tarin should not approach him but ring 999 immediately. Two women were found dead near to their home in North Down Road in Solihull. Tarin is wanted for questioning. Tarin is believed to be the ex-boyfriend of one of the two women found dead in Solihull. Relatives of a mother and daughter who died in a stabbing in Solihull visit the place where the attacks happened this afternoon. Detective Inspector Caroline Caulfield, who is leading the investigation for West Midlands Police, said, we've been working flat out to apprehend Tarin since the early hours of this morning, following up a number of lines of inquiry. As we have so far not been able to locate Tarin, are now asking for the public's help in tracing him. If anyone knows where he is or thinks they may have seen him, I'd urge them to ring 999 immediately. If there's anyone out there who may be shielding him through a sense of misguided loyalty, they need to be aware that they are committing an offense and will be prosecuted. My message to Tarin would be that it's vitally important that we get to speak to you as soon as possible, so please do the right thing and let us know where you are. In a statement, the women's family said, our family is devastated with the loss of our loved ones. Devastated family members visited the victim's home today and declined to comment. Tarin is wanted for questioning after two women died in Solihull over the bank holiday. Police have taped off a section of this suburban street after two women were killed. We would like to give thanks for all the love and support we have received. We kindly request that our privacy is respected at this difficult time. Meanwhile, it was also revealed today that Tarin was reported to police over his threatening behavior by the two women. Police have been accused of ignoring their pleas, and the force, which searched several addresses through the night for Tarin, has referred itself to a watchdog. Tarin is believed to have recently broken up with Ms Oudeh, who relatives claimed has a 15-month-old son. A neighbor told The Times, the mother told me they were having a bit of bother with her daughter's ex-boyfriend. They had recently split up and he kept coming around. They were worried enough to call the police a few times but they weren't taken seriously. Police have cordoned off a green, which has 5 houses facing onto it. Neighbors believe the victims lived in a house on the green, but not that where police activity is focused. Police evidence tents have been put up outside the suburban property following the attacks. West Midlands Police confirmed it had been in contact with the family before the incident, and it has now referred itself to the Independent Office for Police Conduct. Witnesses told of confusing the women's screams for the sound of foxes, while first responders desperately asked neighbors for towels to treat the victims. On a public Facebook page, Tarin posted pro-Syrian messages including, "Pray for Syria," and directed followers to a petition in support of Palestine. There are also several photographs which show him behind the counter of a shop. Tarin's relatives have visited the scene since the incident. It is understood the victims came to the UK from Syria around 16 years ago. Neighbors said they did not believe the mother and daughter lived in the house outside which the tents have been put up. They say the two women lived in another house on the street but ended up outside the home of a neighbor after the attack. Two strips of five terrace houses face onto the green where the police are working. Multiple tents covered the lawn outside a home in Solihull as officers stood guard in the area. Police erected a cordon around the garden of a home where two women died after screaming was heard. Detectives closed off the residential street and are hunting a suspect known to the women. One local resident said she heard screaming and shouting outside late last night. The woman, who asked not to be named, said, "I thought it was foxes screaming. She was absolutely screaming her head off. The man wasn't speaking English, that's for sure. He shouted something and then ran off. There was a lot of screaming and shouting and then I saw a guy run off. About a minute later I saw him leave in a van." The neighbor, who said she was stunned by what had happened, said she did not know the victims, adding that they kept themselves to themselves. Anyone with information has been asked to contact 999.